Well, there's the champ, Tony Lockett, who's kicked 530 goals and six times has been the leading goal kicker here at St Kilda, playing his first match since that Foster's Cup game against West Coast. Welcome to Peter McKenna. It should be a great game, Peter.
It will be a great game. That's an interesting matchup. Nigel Smart, who probably not big enough for Tony Lockett, but then again, and good thinking by Graham Corns, Don, because he might be able to run off him.
Well, I'm impressed with this guy. Every time I've seen Nigel Smart, I like the way he moves. And I think it's a good matchup because he'll run off and put a lot of pressure on Tony Lockett. Interesting, Danny Hughes is line on the interchange. And for St Kilda, we see Newport and Kitschke.
So Newport not used as a tagger. We thought he might have been.
It'll be interesting to see what they do with McGuinness, because he usually cuts them up down here against St Kilda, McGuinness, when he was at Footscray.
Who are you tipping, Peter?
I think the Saints will win by three or four goals, Bruce.
And Don?
Yes, I'm going for St Kilda because this is a difficult ground to play down here and it's a very, very parochial crowd.
Mind you, conditions are absolutely perfect for football, so that gives the Crows a chance. It's a lot harder down here when that wind starts blowing. We just saw a shot of Robert Elphinstone, former great St Kilda halfback, a moment ago.
Good crowd in, and considering the Crows won't have a lot of support, it's terrific to see.
Yes, it'd be 18,000, I'd say, 18 to 20.
So we're set to go. St Kilda kicking to the right, they've got two of their champions back, and the Crows to the left. Tregenza got a touch. Harvey, who's been a big star this year, goes towards full forward. Lockett, what a dream start. Couldn't have asked for more than that, Don.
And you can listen to that crowd. I think the crowd tells the story, doesn't it? It was well done by Harvey. He pinched the ball off McGuinness, deliver it so well, and it was a good lead from Lockett.
Well, will he complete a fairy tale minute in football here by kicking a goal after being out for so long? For weeks and weeks, the Saints have said he'll be back in a fortnight, but that fortnight's gone on and on and on. And can he drill this home from 45 metres? Lockett, familiar pose, drop punt, leans back on it, kicks it straight through the middle. The big boy's back in town.
Well, it's a Hollywood start here at Moorabbin. Tony Lockett involved. There was a great mark. He is very, very good. Very strong hands. Look at this pass by Harvey. There. Well done, Lockett. Taking it out in front of his face.
Back to the centre. Lays a bit of it. Doing the ruck work against Mickenhoff, crashing his way through with Muller. Too easy to the half forward line. Taken away by Bartlett. Bartlett to centre wing. Klug sets himself in front. Can't take the mark. Should have taken that one. Daniels drops the ball. Shuffled out by Pekin. There's Andrew Jarman to McGuinness. McGuinness in great form last week against his old club Footscray. Kicks to the half forward line. This is Cummings kicking it wide. And getting back to that goal by Tony Lockett. Tremendous play by Robert Harvey, because I think it was most important that they get his confidence up very, very early, and I'm sure Harvey would have been thinking of that. Vidovic against Klug. Klug gets it to ground. Jarman, McGuinness, Filkey. Filkey to the half forward line. Should be a mark, and it is. Taken by Muller.
His name in the back pocket. Playing at centre half back is Widmer, who hasn't played since August last year. To Lowe, the champion of the club last season. Bartlett, low on top, wants a free kick. High tackle, no holding the ball.
Very, very slow, wasn't he, Bartlett, on that occasion? You can see there, Lowe playing for it and finally got the free kick.
Lockett the target. Rice, quick kick by Lee to the centre. Front spot, Ralph Smith. Jamison against him. Jarman, Craven, with some pace. One bulk. McAdam in front of Lindsay.
He's moving around a little bit, McAdam. He's lining up over here on centre wing. Now he's deep into that forward line. Lindsay's got the job on him.
McGarry medalist from 1989. Neil Curley, the football manager, would know Gilbert McAdam very well. He coached the Bulldogs in Adelaide when McAdam won the medal. And the drop punt is a good kick. And he's just hit the post. So it's 1-1 the Saints, and the Crows yet to score.
I was really interested in the way he kicked the ball then, Peter. The head right over the ball as he made contact. Classical.
short kick by Scott Lee has found Maynard. Back it comes to Lee. Lee, well, he took a chance, but he gets away with it to the half back line. Micken is the flyer. And Mark Micken, formerly of the Brisbane Bears, takes the kick to half forward. Players set themselves. It's punched on. That was Coughlin. Further afield to Ralph Smith. Then on to Harvey. Harvey wide. Stewart low. 20 metres. Oh, he's fumbled again against Bartlett. Bartlett didn't grab it this time. He's tripped over, though. That allows Lowe. Again, Lowe's fumbled. Not in good form. And that could be holding it again. No, it's not. Bartlett. The centre wing, McDermott, has taken a good strong mark. They need a big game from Chris McDermott. Bruce Lindsay to half forward, over the back. A chance for the Crows. Out comes Hodges. I'll certainly appreciate his presence back in the side. Umpire calls play on as Craven comes away from half back. Kicks it wide and he's found the man. Will he take it? No, he doesn't. Play on, the umpire calls it. Frank Coughlin. Coughlin coming through centre to half forward. He's found his man and this is Russell Morris.
In the centre square, Lockett wide, there's the target, Rice in the front spot, or free kick Lockett. Play on called, Rice to kick another one. Bang, through. Two goals, one St Kilda, Adelaide yet to score.
Well, as we saw there, it was a two-on-one situation, Lockett being outnumbered. And here it is, the build-up. Now watch as Morris gets it and delivers it on quickly. It's a high ball. Lockett will be on the lead. There you can see the hand over the shoulder. Scott Lee in front, Smart behind. Comes to ground. And Rice finishes off.
Great start to the Saints. Again, it's Vidovic versus Micken. Micken taps it down. They barely need to get it out of the centre. Here's Peakin. Now it's Russell Morris. They're getting it far too easily out of the centre. Craven to half forward. Dean Rice in front of Scott Lee. It is Mark Rice. Where's Lockett? They're not giving him a lot of room right now. Now the lead is on. Lockett comes from the side. Stewart low. Oh, too big, too strong, too good.
Well, haven't they got a potent forward line when you've got Morris who's moving so well, also Lowe has finally taken a mark. He hasn't handled the ball too cleanly. And you've also got Lockett up there. Throw in Widmar if he gets up around that line, and also McAdam. It is a very potent line.
Well, they've got a Russell Jeffrey played in the seconds and was outstanding, so it won't be long before he's in the side. They're almost getting to full strength, the Saints. Lowe from directly in front. Kicks a goal. It's another one. Three goals, one St Kilda. The Adelaide Crows yet to score.
What Adelaide will have to do is look at the centre line, because they're not winning the ball across the centre at all. Craven's doing particularly well. He's manning up on McGuinness, playing him man-to-man. Now Hart's gone in as roving.
Well, it's interesting, Don. McGuinness 19-0. Interesting that McGuinness and Jarman haven't really had an effective touch yet in the centre square, and they've been the playmakers. There was Jarman, McDermott, now Abernethy with a high one to half forward. Murphy and Grant against him. Ralph Smith. Go a bit slow there. Tregenza got hold of him. I wasn't at Windy Hill when Essendon played the Crows, but I know both you were, Peter and Don, and it was a similar start. They were just a bit overwhelmed early and then hung on after that.
Yes, that's quite true, Bruce. And they didn't have Hodges that day. They fell down badly up forward. That was Vidovic hooking it out to Craven, a good little player, Craven. It was grabbed high, I would feel.
He's figured prominently, hasn't he, Craven, early in this game?
He was taken off last week and Jimmy Cracker brought on. I thought it was a wrong decision at the time, trying to get team balance going. But that's McDermott giving it across to Jarman. Jarman to Hodges, led well, trapped it well. Frawley is in for a tough day on Frawley, though. Frawley hooks it out. There's a quick hand pass. Muller tries to crash his way through the pack. Now it's McGuinness. He's brought to ground. Still umpire calling play on. Muller to Nathan Burke. Out wide is Marshall, leading in the race against Widmar. They love Widmar here. The crowd roars. Taken away by Burke. A very talented player. Half forward is Russell Morris. And over the back, a good mark to Maynard, who's very strong overhead, Don.
He's a good player. I like this fellow.
Short to Lindsay in the centre square. Winmar late. Low and Lockett both prominent early. Lindsay to half forward. Grant in the front spot against Murphy.
Bradley directed that kick.
Kicked six goals against Footscray Murphy. Here's McAdam. Gee, Peter, McAdam and Winmar, if they can start to combine together, won't that be exciting this year?
I saw McAdam last week in a losing side. He was brilliant. The ball at half forward, Peakin, a shocking kick, straight to Micken. And it was intended for Lockett, on to Bartlett. Bartlett, he's in for a tough day too, playing on Stuart Lowe. To centre wing, a one-on-one contest. Tregenza couldn't take it. Klug shuffles it out. This is Marshall, Abernethy. Half forward is Murphy. Used his body beautifully on that occasion. On it goes to Filkey, running around in circles. Now the short one is wide. Now Klug or Hodges should get here now. Oh, bad miss by John Klug. An easy mark. Kicked away by Nathan Burke. You cannot afford to do that, particularly down here at Moorabbin. They don't give you many chances. That was poorly receiving from Harvey. Nathan Burke to half forward and Russell Morris. The ball hits the deck. Oh, Winmar. Well done, Winmar. Loses it in the tackle. Now Morris, ridden into the ground. Umpire called play on, it'll be a bounce.
Positive start by the Saints. Adelaide struggling across half forward. Bad mistake, as Peter said a moment ago, by Klug. Low to do the ruck work against Micken. Got a bit of a height to St Kilda. Winmar. Quick kick, Lockett. And Smart. Smart read that well. Very talented young player to Lindsay. At halfback. Centre wing, Klug in the front spot, Muller over the back, and touched out of bounds. So a throw in right in front of our commentary position. Big crowd here at Moorabbin has built up in the last half hour, and the Saints away to a flying start.
Ball on centre wing, the St Kilda players wearing black armbands in memory of former champion halfback Eric Guy, one of the toughest players to ever play the game, as the umpires found a free kick. You remember Eric Guy, Don?
Yes, I do, actually.
The late Eric Guy was a genuinely tough player. Danny Craven to half forward, and the mark has been taken by Micken, who seems to be a better player with the Crows than he was with the Brisbane Bears. Micken to centre wing. Marshall at the back. Read it well. Plays on. Hart to Klug. Now Klug should have a bounce. He goes for a hand pass instead. Filkey. Where's Hodges? Hodges leads to the pocket. A disgraceful kick. A shocker. Straight along the ground. Oh, Hodges. Is that a free kick? No. The umpire calls play on as the quick kick. No, it's a free kick for over the neck on Tony McGuinness. And this kick will be taken about 20 metres from goal on a very, very acute angle.
Well, the man standing the mark there, young Steve Cummings, he's been down here a long time. He broke his leg a couple of years ago. He's really worked hard to get himself back in a reserves best and fairest. And he's actually been through four drafts.
Tony McGuinness getting around, opening up the goals and kicks. Oh, not a bad looking drop punt. Is it across the face or just in? It's just missed. But tried to open up the goals. Obviously can't kick the check side, Bruce.
And no right foot either.
Made famous in Adelaide by Jack Odie. And Stuart Lowe at the back. Filkey probably got first grab. Winmar has had a prominent start. McAdam and Lindsay. Missed by Marshall. Harvey, good hands there. Was through his legs. Well-directed kick to Morris in the front spot. Free kick. Will come back. Had a good look there, Harvey. Gave Morris a chance.
Morris was outstanding last week on Steve Kernahan in a losing side. He played a great game at centre half back.
He's an improved player, isn't he? Couldn't get a game at Hawthorne.
Got a lot to prove.
So Morris to the goal square, and the obvious target is Lockett. A couple against him, Rice and Lee. Lee to the safety of the boundary line. And St Kilda deep into attack, and this Adelaide defence under tremendous pressure in the early part of the game. There's Scott Lee, who played so well last week against Footscray.
Yes, a good honest goer, Scott Lee. Ball in that back pocket here. Andrew Jarman was grabbed by the jumper, and the umpire found it. A free kick holding the man, the short one. And they're trying to run off Tony Lockett.
That's good play. I hope Smart continues that.
That is good play. Nigel Smart, that's obviously the reasoning behind putting him there and not Danny Hughes. There's Jason Daniels with a quick hand pass. Robert Harvey, a very talented player, on to Pekin. Now Nathan Burke from 55 metres, the short one, is a bad kick. And is that 50 metres? No, the mark is taken by Lee. Micken, Filkey. Filkey to centre wing, or the height here certainly favoured Vidovic. Played on. On to Pekin. Pekin or a hand pass to a man who was covered. 35 is Jamison. Jamison trying to shuffle it out to Marshall. On to Jarman, who punched it away, then was held. Very clever play that by Andrew Jarman, and a free kick.
Did very well last week after being taken off in the first quarter, Jarman.
Chop punter, centre half forward. Murphy in the front spot. Maynard caught. She's covering a bit of ground, Maynard. He was in the back pocket a moment ago.
Well, if we go back to the first game the Crows played against Hawthorn, he kicked two or three goals running off that half back line on Paul Deere. It was a terrific effort.
Vidovic and Klug to do the ruck work. Crows need a goal here. They've steadied after being shell-shocked early. Hart has forced his way back in. Peeking round the corner. Micken takes a chance. Morris on the up to Winmar. He should kick it to McAdam, and he does. He's got low inside if he sees him. Goes the direct way to Lockett. It's a great kick. And both Smart and Lee able to do the sandwich job on the big fellow.
And that's a chance where Lockett could have possibly led to that ball because his man was free.
I was interested the way the ball got down there. McAdam's getting away from Lindsay.
Oh, good player, McAdam. He was another great player for St Kilda last week in the losing side. They had about four really top players that kept him in it. Look at Lowe, the big arms. Oh, the ball hit him in the head. Marshall to Filkey. Two of their key players. Filkey inside. Great play, Grant Filkey. Now they need someone to do something decisive here. Over the back. Here's a chance for Hart. Hart trying to give it back to Hodges and Tregenza. Tregenza, a hurry kick to the half forward line. It's thumped the ground. The Saints through Frawley to Cummings. This is Robert Harvey. Oh, brilliant play. Daniels, the short one. Morris. And they've got too many loose men at the moment, the Saints.
Morris from the centre square, Winmar in the hands of the trainer, and Lowe hitting the head with the ball like he was last week at Princess Park. Lockett again, three players against him, and two Saints down. Coughlin, Lee did well to cut him off. Coughlin tried to tap it back to Lockett, missed him. Ooh, quick hands. Is that a throw by Abernethy? It was very quick. Jarman now the target from Lindsay. Daniels. Oh, play, Jarman. Absolutely brilliant. Beat two of them there. Tregenza went to water, panicked when he shouldn't have. Took his eye off it and then wanted to thump it away. Missed by Lindsay. McAdam, Craven, good back turn, clever roving. Caught in the end. Allowed to play on to Coughlin from 50 metres. Coughlin to Lockett. And you can't beat him when they kick it like that to him.
Just impossible. Just impossible. Smart behind. And Lockett is just too big. Now watch this. Well done, Craven. Coughlin. He is just too big, Lockett, and Smart just didn't have the run. They've got to drop their ruckman. They've been doing that well, dropping another ruckman down there on Lockett. Smart might need a handout.
Must have been a fine line between whether that was holding the ball on Danny Craven too, Bruce.
Very close, and in the end it was almost around the legs, but this is Lockett's bread and butter, isn't it, to be in front and holding out somebody like Smart. Oh,
too strong, too big.
For his second goal and the Saints' fourth, no mistake. Lockett's got two. St Kilda away. They're 4-2 and the Crows are a point.
Well, Tony Lockett wearing that number four. It's a famous number down here. Worn by Darryl Baldock when he was captain in the early 60s. Then Barry Breen took the number over. He played over 300 games, Barry Breen. Now Tony Lockett has it.
Four-two to a solitary point to the Crows. The Saints doing it well here. They go forward again. It was Daniels to McAdam, and now on to Winmar. Lockett again. Oh, he nearly took it. Push in the back. And that was good play by Smart. He got in front on that occasion.
Adelaide have made a change. They've got Lindsay now on Coughlin, and Abernathy's come across onto McAdam.
This is Maynard. A couple of bounces. Can go over the top of the hand pass here. He does to Bartlett. Bartlett long to the half forward line. They're not moving around much. Grant on Murphy. Here's a chance. Hart, Tregenza. Now a one-on-one contest. Hodges, front position. Punched down by Frawley. He's very, very strong, Danny Frawley. Taps it wide. Good defensive play. This is Jamison. Oh, handball straight to Harvey. Back it comes to Frawley. Frawley heads around the boundary line. Very, very good defensive play.
Interesting, Frawley and Hodges, when they went for that ball. I thought that Frawley was hanging on to Hodges, not going for the ball, but holding him down.
He's playing his 150th today, Frawley, the captain. Klug and Vidovic. Hart, who's had a couple of good touches with the hands. Kicked a lot of goals in one of the Foster's Cup matches early on. Just maybe a lack of pace the reason he's been struggling.
Been around a long time.
Yeah. Central Districts and North Adelaide. Best footy at North Adelaide. Klug just pushes Vidovic in the back. No free kick. Burke to centre wing. Maynard, Micken at the back. Winmar read it well. This is what they love to see with pace. Kick it to Lockett. Look at this. Well, the two heroes.
Oh, this isn't he, Meg? I mean, if a footballer's beautiful, the way that Winmar moves, it's just it is just fantastic.
Both of them, Don, too. A great lead by Lockett. He wouldn't have the match fitness, but I reckon they've got an extra 5,000 people here today because of those two coming back.
Jarman has come off for Adelaide. And coming on is Mark Bickley, the rover.
Be interesting to see if Jarman's injured or just taken off. It'd be surprising if he's not injured. Now Lockett from 45 metres. Can he kick his third? It's already been a fairy tale start for him. Leans back, drop, punt, misses. Just hooked it. Probably trying to get a bit more distance there. And they're up to 4-3, the Saints, and the Crows are a point. Did Jarman look all right to you, Don?
It seemed to be. He walked around there without any assistance. One of the officials got up to speak to him, but it wasn't a doctor, so...
Just wait for Max Stevens. Well, just looking on the bench, he seemed to be grimacing a fair bit. There's Abernathy coming to the half-forward line and Klug. Now, will it sit for him? Klug tries to tap it back into play, but it beat him over the line, and the camera shot of Jarman showed him grimacing, so maybe there was an injury there because I think he's been one of their better players with that slick handball. Vidovic, formerly of North Melbourne, trying to resurrect his career. He's really hung into this AFL football. The ball on centre wing. The players pushing and shoving. McGuinness is pinged for holding the ball. And it's a free kick there going to Kitschke to centre wing. And the mark has been taken by Morris. Morris to Lowe. Lowe's got two to beat. It's thumped the ground. Oh, player slipping over there. Bartlett to Lee. Further afield it goes to Tregenza. Tregenza to the half-forward line. The ball hits the deck. Oh, they're falling down badly at half-forward. Number 22 is Murphy. Oh, shocking play. Straight to Nathan Burke. On to Pekin. Pekin to the half-forward line. McAdam waits for it. Now sits on top of it. Umpire doesn't penalise him. A little bit lucky.
Max, what's the situation with Andrew Jarman?
Situation with Andrew Jarman, it would appear that he's been dragged at this point of time. Doctors aren't talking to him and he's just sitting on the bench with his head between his knees.
Mickens tap, Pekin, Winmar. Again lock at the target. Well, it's a pleasure to watch at the moment unless you're back in Adelaide and barracking your heart out for the Crows.
He's just too big for Smart. They've got to get
down. Not really. Yeah, but I watched it on that occasion. He was indecisive, Lockett, as to what he was doing. He didn't know what Winmar was going to do. He wanted it long. He got behind. He led left, right, and then just got in front at the critical time. Everything's going just too well for St Kilda at the moment. They can't do anything wrong. And the Crows have got to improve.
Oh, you'd have to get Denny Hughes there quick, Smart. At least he has played on him before and has got strength.
Lockett's also kicked a few goals.
I know.
Hughes.
I realise that.
Well, he's about to kick his third here. Straight through for another one. Well, Lockett's got three, and it's 5-3 to a point. And Don Scott, if you were a Hollywood producer, you wouldn't have written a script like this. This has been perfect.
Well, I was thinking exactly the same thing, Bruce. You know, this stuff's made in Hollywood, isn't it? But then again, St Kilda can do no wrong, and it's a little bit of a worry when you do it so easily as Watson Kilda, because the opposition are going to improve. They only just have to get start winning the ball and they'll be back in the game.
Magnificent start by the St Kilda champion. 5-3 plays a point. And Lockett is slotted back into that lineup as if he'd been playing all year. Now, here's a free kick going the way of Chris McDermott. And, gee, they've been falling down at half forward.
Playing too short, Peter. Every time they get the ball forward, they go short.
Well, here's their chance now. Hodges at the back. Went for it one-handed. Couldn't do anything about it. Ball at half forward. Robert Harvey, dispossessed. Sean Ralph Smith, former Hawthorn player, kicks long to the half forward line. Maynard waits for the bounce. Oh, this is danger because Coughlin's got it. An open goal, short pass. And Nigel Smart couldn't do a thing about that one. That is brilliant football by the Saints. Great lead by Lockett. And determination plus.
Well, in actual fact, Coughlin might have been able to kick this. They are very much Lockett conscious. It was only a 20-metre pass. It was a good pass.
Well, he is a champion. How do you stop him? Tony Lockett from 30 metres, directly in front. Plenty of time over this kick. There it is. Another one on the board for the Saints. Four to Lockett. 6-3, St Kilda. The Adelaide Crows remain on one solitary point.
Well, I simply think you can sum it up as being unbelievable. You'll have to be here to watch it. There, Maynard making a mistake. A lot of those little mistakes are happening and the St Kilda players capitalising, and Coughlin capitalised on that fumble.
...39-1... a remarkable start at Moorabbin. Craven to Daniels. It's smothered off the boot by Bickley. Klug tries to break a tackle. Hart tries to get a kick away. Again smothered. Pekin. Winmar drops it. Should have gone. Gets it back to Pekin. Lockett on another lead. Not this time. Front spot. No free kick paid to Lee. Rice. Good play by Tregenza to get in Winmar's throw. Strong bump there. Tregenza again to Marshall, who'll chip it over towards Bickley. And this should sit for him. And he should attack here.
Oh.
Well, you wouldn't read about that one, would you, to Muller?
Gusting kick.
And Muller now to McAdam, and the Saints are in again.
Oh, some of the field kicking of the Crows at the moment is abysmal. Now, here's Dean Rice. Dropped the mark. But they're still in the band through Coughlin. Lockett. Oh, he couldn't grab that one. Lowe. Maynard. Lockett again. He'll be feeling the pinch, Tony Lockett, in the moment. He lies on the ball, Tony Lockett. And he's been pinged for holding the ball. And a correct decision as McDermott kicks wide to Marshall, and Marshall can run away.
To half forward, Klug and Jamieson are there.
Good, good mark.
Used his body well. Hodges, poor kick again. Frawley's going to come at the back. Almost a spectacular mark. Burke goes to ground. Good handball though to Grant. Now Daniels, there's a paddock in front of him. Runs his 8 or 10 metres and kicks it towards Lockett and also Rice. Lee, Bartlett, snared by Morris. Lindsay misses it. Maynard to Lee, to Smart, to Maynard. Now can the Crows get something to work? Klug on a lead. Muller interferes with him. No free kick. Pekin and also Hart. And again a ball up.
Just talking about Tony Lockett, he's the focal point. You go down the other end there, he's looking for petrol tickets. His hands are on his knees, he's bent over. So obviously he's not too fit.
I'll tell you what though, he's 6'4" and about 16 stone. He just has to put his big backside in the goal scorer. It'd be hard to beat. He's holding the ball. Free kick to Harvey. The short one is on. Oh, the Crows are not manning up because here's Winmar loose. He'll kick it long. No, he dodges. Now he'll kick it long and high. This could be a goal. Yes, it is another one to the Saints. Nicky Winmar has kicked his first. St Kilda steaming ahead, 7-3, 45 to Adelaide Crows, one behind.
Well, it was only a few minutes ago. St Kilda were about 26 points in front. They'd controlled the quarter. But in the last few minutes, they've really rammed the goals on. Three, in fact. And it's now made their lead very respectable.
Mickin. Quick kick by Pekin. That's Winmar's 150th goal in league footy. in 81 games since coming from South Fremantle in 87. It's a pretty good average. Morris, a good finger tipper. Gee, it's one-way traffic, isn't it? Morris towards Rice on a lead. In the front spot,
well
lead.
Well done. That was good play then.
Micken. Somebody's got to stop the gate, and the floodgates have got to be closed for Adelaide. Jamieson. Lee, he followed up, quick kick. He wants Klug to take a mark here. Hart tries to snare it on the ground. Vidovic off the ground. Harvey, good hip and shoulder on him by Murphy. Another strong tackle on Craven. Burt free kick in the back.
And Bickley's hurt too after laying that tackle.
And there's a blue on behind play.
It was interesting. Hart, when he had to go for the ball earlier in the season, would have gone. Just stood back and allowed the St Kilda player in.
So high drama at Moorabbin with the siren sounding. And the Saints by 44 points in a quarter of footy. They're going to remember here for a long time. 7-3 to a point. So the Saints to the left and Adelaide to the right. Micken and Vidovic. Just have a look for us, Don, and see if Jarman's gone back on. McGuinness, Filkey. Still Filkey. Wasted the footy in the first quarter with three or four kicks. That's a high, slow one. Took forever to get there. And Hodges and Frawley, and it'll be a ball up.
No.
So Hughes is on, and it looks like Jarman's still on the interchange.
Yeah, I can't pick up Jarman at all, Bruce.
He's got to be injured. You wouldn't leave him on there for that long.
Well, smart. I don't know about taking him off the ground. He's a real good player. I think a change of position would have been better for him. There's a quick kick by McDermott to the half-forward line. They badly need a couple of quick goals, the Crows, to get something moving. Saints have done it easy. Here's David Grant, a very, very good player, Grant. He's got some strength now, St Kilda, in this side. Or was that a free kick? Was the mark anyway to Abernathy? Talented player. Had a lot of AFL experience. Bruce Abernathy to half forward. Klug versus Muller. Punched away by Muller. The Saints again through Harvey. The running player is Ralph Smith. Oh, backup support from Nathan Burke. Burke to the half forward line. A shocking kick. Straight to Bartlett.
Quick give to Lee. And
oh!
Winmar. Lockett.
Well, Bruce, so we're only just into the second quarter and the wheels are starting to fall up as far as Adelaide are concerned. Lee should have got rid of that ball so much sooner. He just went two steps too long. And it was a great tackle. And look what happens.
Well, the Saints have made the Crows pay for their mistakes. Was this? He froze there, Lee, wasn't he?
He just went too long, didn't he?
That's when you haven't got confidence
well,
in
that's
your
right,
players
Peter.
Upfield.
Yeah.
That happens.
Also.
Well, Lockett for his fifth. Kicks it across the front. And he's kicked four goals, two. So the Saints are up to 7-4 to a point.
The one thing about Danny Hughes, now, Danny Hughes will always be beaten by a quick leading full forward. But if you kick it high, he's a difficult player to beat because he's very, very strong. And Lockett will know that, even though he's strong himself. But he will keep leading on Hughes. Now, the short one by Scott Lee has found Bruce Lindsay. Lindsay to the half-back line. And a good strong mark by Russell Morris. You can see he's got a player that has regained his confidence. Beautiful mark and a long driving drop punt. Stuart Lowe can't take the mark. Here's Peakin, hooks it back in front of goal. Oh, Lockett's on his own. No one's near him. Oh, Danny Hughes 25 metres away, left Lockett, and Lockett has been given a gift.
What you can do if you're the coach is you sit there and shake your head in amazement.
Well, you wouldn't leave him alone, would you? Tony Lockett, he's kicked four and missed two. I don't think he'll miss this one from directly in front. Tony Lockett for his fifth. Bang. It's a goal. 5 goals to Tony Lockett. The Saints steaming ahead. 8-4-52. Adelaide 1 point.
Well, he's had 7 shots at goal. 5 goals, 2. And St Kilda have a total of 8 scoring shots. So Lockett. 12 scoring shots at goal, so Lockett contributing well over half.
What a remarkable scoreline, 52-1, and Lockett with 5 goals. Marshall, Hodges. That was Cummings to Frawley, to Grant. Well, they're playing with tremendous confidence. Not a good kick. I say not a good kick. It was a tumbler, but it found Vidovic. To centre half forward low. Bartlett did a good job that time. Lindsay and Hughes. Hughes' quick kick, but ill-directed. Daniels. Tregenza with him. Over the top. And Burke just given a little shove by Bickley. And it'll be a throw-in.
Well, I saw St Kilda play last week, and I've got no doubt whatsoever if Winmar and Lockett were playing, it could have been a different result. They had tons of the ball against Carlton. They couldn't kick goals. There's Marshall to the half forward line. Punched away by Ralph Smith, straight to Filkey. Filkey on the left foot should set it up maybe for a goal here. There's the kick up into the square. Frawley at the back. Grant, sock it off the ground. And it is actually a point. It's forced over the line. So that's another behind to Adelaide. They're still yet to open their account with a goal. But St Kilda remain on 8-4. It's been a whitewash so far.
Frawley. Bangs it to half-back, low the target. Bartlett against him. Harvey. To Morris, playing in front of Maynard. Oh. To Daniels. Again, Lockett on a lead. Well done, Hughes. Stayed with him all the way. Lee. Hughes again. Good handle. McGuinness has been very quiet. Two bounces. A third. He's trying to draw Winmar. Goes to Filkey now. Stop, start again. Handball out to Bartlett. He's got Klug inside of him. Left foot looking for Hodges. Vidovic in the front. Hodges does well to spoil. Klug goes to ground. Traps the footy. Harvey's quick kick. Craven concedes some ground. Burke. Good tackle. Bickley. Now McGuinness with a chance. Still McGuinness. Drop punt. Good kick. Set it up nicely. And Murphy's taken the mark in the pocket. I know they've had to go away from the goal front. But it's the first time Adelaide's found a man when going into attack. Michael Murphy, who kicked 6 goals against Footscray. And to say that Adelaide need this would be one of the understatements of the 91 season. She's dropped punt. Good looking kick. Might have just got it through. He has. A goal to Adelaide. Murphy's first. Adelaide's first. They're 1-2 to 8-4.
Well, 6 goals last week, Murphy. You go back a couple of years ago, he was a North Melbourne player, only played a handful of games. And St Kilda's still going, as we see here, still going in hard for the ball. It spills out to McGuinness. He spots Murphy, who didn't let him down.
Badly needed one to Adelaide. They need 3 or 4 more quick ones to get themselves back in this game. There's Coughlin off the side of the boot. Felke ran past the ball. And that could be holding the ball. It'll be a free kick going the way of the Crows.
He should have pushed it on. He made play Craven, but he just didn't follow it up. He just didn't push it out. He tried to trap the ball.
Marshall, the centre wing. And it makes a big difference when McGuinness is firing. On it goes to Felke. Ran too far. Gets his kick in. Then it rebounded back to him. Here's a chance for a kick at goal by Bickley and hit the post. So that makes it one poster apiece. Well, that would have lifted them a little bit if he could have kicked that one, but he missed. 1-3 plays 8-4.
Marshall doing some good work in the centre. And Filkey getting some touches. Still wasting a few balls. Frawley's kick's a good one. Bartlett, Lowe and Micken. Quick kick by Harvey. And it's going to come back to him.
Yeah, he's down after he got rid of the ball, Harvey.
It should be down the ground.
So Harvey to centre wing. Rice on his own. And a lot of St Kilda players in that situation today. Squeezes it beautifully to Morris in the centre square. It's got Winmar wide. Everyone looking for Lockett. What will he do? Morris has kicked. Lockett the target. Ooh. Through the fingers. Hughes. Daniels. Tregenza. Still Daniels. Had plenty of time to think about it. McAdam. Well, Abernethy will be disappointed there. 7 kicks for McAdam.
Interesting to see what Mickham's doing off the ball. He's gone back to man up on Lockett. Hughes running up the ground. There was also a good block earlier by Mickham to get there and contest against Lockett because St Kilda are predictable. They're looking for Lockett on every occasion.
McAdam from 50 metres. Morris in the front. Mickens punch away. Now Hughes and Hart.
Darryl Hart on the left foot. Oh, he's kicked it. He didn't really have anyone to kick it to. They'll be hoping this bounces out. It doesn't. Winmar to Harford. Micken should snaffle this one. He does. Mark Micken taking over the number one ruck mantle from Negri. Umpire's called play on here. He's gone short. He's found Chris McDermott. Oh, a little chip pass. Set. Oh, boy. Lucky to get away with it. Free kick was paid. Then the advantage to McGuinness. Is starting to come into the game. Here's Muller, Ralph Smith, two players that were discarded by other clubs. Burke to centre wing and McAdam. The ball hits the deck.
Well done, Daniels.
Well done by Jason Daniels. You heard Don Scott say on the peak and all they're desperate, the Saints. Chris McDermott, well played. Darryl Hart, wide. Scott Lee, looking for someone to give it to. Chips it back. That was excellent play to Crew.
Wasn't a good kick by Lee, but it still found its mark in Klug.
It's got Jamison, Murphy and Hodges all in the goal square.
It's a bit slow.
Gee, what a difference. Hodges returned to league football and Lockett's. I mean, Hodges not out for as long, I know, but Scotty hasn't had a touch.
Good kick.
Torpedo punt. Kicked it very long. Not quite straight enough. And Vidovic claims the mark and given it. Goes to play on. Gee's in trouble here. He'll have to concede a behind. And he has. So the Crows are up to 1-3. And St Kilda are 8-4. 1-4 to 8-4.
I think, Bruce, the worst player, if you're out for a while with an injury, the worst player you could come back if you're full forward and play on would be Danny Frawley. For the half-back line. Because he pushes, shoves, scrags. He's desperate. And he's a very good player with it. There's Winmar. To half forward, McAdam is the flyer and can't take it. And the South Australians would certainly know Gilbert McAdam, former Central District star and won the McGarry. And that could be a free kick, is it?
It is going to McAdam.
So that must have been after the out-of-bounds decision, Don. Something must have happened as McAdam to the half forward line. Micken reads it well, but a push out.
It's to Morris. It's pushed out.
Well, he's one out Lockett on Hughes. If he kicks it quickly... There's the kick. Lockett takes front position. Here he comes. Ooh, pushed out. Yes, a free kick to Lockett. Given away by Hughes. No doubt about that free kick.
And well, I suppose he was either going to take the mark. And Hughes and was committed.
A show of strength by Lockett. And he took front position. And that's why he got the free kick.
Now watch this on replay.
Oh, yeah, across the air. No wonder Lockett was remonstrating. He's kicked five. What a comeback. Unbelievable. Probably not fit as far as match fitness. Certainly not. And he's lining up his sixth goal. Well, he is a great player. Tony Lockett. For the Saints' ninth goal. There's the kick. Oh, another poster. Bad luck. He's got enough pride to be very, very dirty on that. He's racing down to save a few words, I think.
8-5-1-4. Lee. Hughes. Oh, gee, Lockett's just charged into him there.
That's against Lockett.
And so it should be. Pretty ordinary performance, that one, by the big fella.
I agree. I tell you what, that was very close to reportable.
Well, he just took his eye off the foot. He's given 50 metres away, and the reason he has is because he trod on Hughes's head. Here we go.
Here we go.
Well, if Dermot...
That was fair enough.
If Dermot Brereton had seen that one, he got 5 weeks for the similar...
Oh, Peter, it was different. You can't compare the two of them.
You reckon, Don?
My word.
It was different, was it?
My word, completely different.
Hughes to Marshall. And there'll be a throw-in. Well, you might get an argument on that one, Donnie.
You'll get it from me for a start, but...
It wouldn't be hard to argue with you anyway.
It'll be interesting. Hughes has gone back to Stan Lockett now, and I think a few words might be said.
Well, the whole point, the ball wasn't there, was it?
Daniels to Craven, who's been the best of the Rovers. Rice the target here, all Winmar. Oh, Specky to Rice. Lockett one out again. He'll kick it to him again, and he'll take another one. Well, you can mouth off and let Danny know all about it, but no one could have stopped Lockett there.
It was quite interesting. As that ball was coming down and just before Rice marked the ball, Lockett had his back to the play. I mean, he's really hit a purple patch. Then he leads out. He's in front of Hughes. He's not quick Hughes. But the ball was delivered so well out in front of him. Well, I mean, this is just a purple patch, Peter, isn't it?
Well, the way St Kilda are playing, no one, there was not Danny Hughes' fault. No one will stop Lockett because they're kicking so well to him and you've got a champion full forward leading, so.
And they're giving him some room, which is all important. He had a paddock to run into there. Okay, Lockett for goal number six. He's got it. Well, it's Don mentioned unbelievable earlier on. And again, Hughes and Lockett are at it. You can see Hughes with a bloodied nose. And it's 9-5 to 1-4.
And Bruce, that's where he's so good, Lockett, though. He does intimidate opponents, you know, with his size and strength. And not many full forwards are normally copying it from backmen. But Lockett gives as much as he takes. You can see the cut above the eye of Danny Hughes. And that'll be the emergency umpire out there talking to Lockett and Hughes. 9-5 plays 1-4. Micken trying to get it out of the centre to Lindsay. Lindsay to half forward. This is Hart versus Cummings. To half back is Grant Filkey. They need to get something moving, the Crows. Marshall, he's been good. Hodges, no, he's playing today. Playing, oh, sock it off the ground by Clue. Went about 50 metres and straight over the line.
But well, he's well within on record to kick to set a record, isn't he, Lockett? He's got six to date, and we're only halfway through the second quarter. The record is 14, held by John Coleman back in 1954.
Klug, McDermott, snapped by Bickley, and just missing. So the Crows are up to 1-5 to 9-5. The emergency umpire, as we showed you as we first came back from that break, talking to Lockett, and the Adelaide runner has gone out to talk to Hughes, and we believe Smart's about to come back on. So it's all happening here. 9-5, 1-5. Lowe. So aren't they a better side suddenly with Lockett and Winmar, because Lowe's got a bit of freedom and the permutations are so much more and so varied. There's Morris, missed by Lindsay, Coughlin, Pekin, Daniels caught by Lindsay, Pekin again, free kick to Daniels.
Well, Bruce, it's two champions coming back into the side. There's Kitsky about to come on. Oh, Dean Rice has dropped the centre. Scott Lee. Kitsky on, Vidovic off for the Saints. Here's Muller. Burke, oh, they're playing with confidence. Ralph Smith, McAdam. Oh, grab that down quickly. Good play, McAdam. They're all playing well.
Oh, this
well.
Is good by Ralph Smith. Ralph he delivered Smith. The ball.
Ralph Smith has followed on to half forward. Where's Lockett? Here he comes at the back. Can he get there? He flies. Two bites. It's a mark. Oh, he's on fire, Tony Lockett. He's kicked six. And he will kick from 35 directly in front. And the St Kilda crowd are ecstatic.
Well, he's behind this time. Makes first grab at it. Micken doing the right thing in front, but Lockett just too high. And Hughes coming off. Well, that's Smart coming on now. Whether they bring Smart back onto Lockett or make a change, we'll just wait and see.
Well, I feel for Hughes at the moment.
So do I.
Ordinary effort to pull him off under those circumstances.
I reckon that is the worst thing I've seen in years, that. I really do. To drag a man off in front of the St Kilda stand. Here's Lockett, by the way, having a kick. And he has put it through. Seven goals, Tony Lockett. St Kilda 10-5 to 1-5.
Well, Smart looks like he's going to go on the half-back line. Maynard has got the job.
But Don, I cannot believe a coach would drag a player
off
like
that.
Yes, but
Peter, no, in all fairness, now listen, Smart was warming up on the boundary line before Lockett had taken that mark. So obviously they were going to make a move. Get Hughes off, put Maynard to full-back, and Smart will probably go half-back.
Well, 65 to 11. At Moravan, free kick to Lowe. And the wheels have just fallen off for Adelaide.
Well, I think that's the most belittling thing I've seen in a long time. I really mean that, to do that to a player.
Tafuse dragged off under those circumstances. Here's Maynard. Free kick to Lockett against
Shepherding, Lee. Shepherding. You can see there that Maynard and Micken were in front and behind play. Lockett was shepherded off the ball. And Scott Lee there protesting.
I thought they were a little bit stiff there.
Well, I mean, Peter, I mean, it's shepherding.
I'd like to see it again. Now, have a look.
Well, there, see, he had no, he did not have any intent on the ball whatsoever, Scott Lee.
I thought the guy held his ground.
Yeah, but he didn't.
You're allowed to hold your ground in football, Don.
Well, Murphy's gone off and Hughes has come back on. So, lock it for number eight. You better get that record book out, Donnie, because he's put it through. It's another one. Well, it's one of the most remarkable chapters in the history of football, this. 11-5 to 1-5. We've seen things at Moorabbin today that will be remembered forever. And, well, I'm like you, Peter. I reckon Lee was standing there and had his eye on the footy. Still, Don, we can't always agree with you. Eight goals to lock it.
You are allowed to hold your ground. As simple as that.
Well, 11-5 to 1-5, and the big fellow's got eight. Did you ever kick eight before half-time?
Well, I'll tell you something. The league record is in a chance today. 17 goals is the... Or is it 18, Don? We'll have to check on that. There's a kick to the half-forward line. Bartlett, he's kicked eight, and he has been magnificent. What a great comeback, and it has really lifted the crowd. Lindsay to half-forward. Denny Hughes back on the ground. To the half-forward line goes Hughes. Hart trapped it well, doesn't get the bounce. Now he's got a Darryl Hart. Hand pass back. Jamison has got it. Tries a banana kick and hits the post. That deserved a goal. It was a good attempt, but the Crows cannot do a thing right.
Well, he should have really centred that ball back, and because Bickley was back in the centre of the ground. Had he just lifted his eyes, he would have spotted Bickley by himself.
Frawley. Low the target. Bartlett makes front position and Micken. Now McGuinness. Harvey. Pressure from Bickley. Harvey taps it to Pekin. Bickley hangs in there. Now Winmar, who was electrifying in the first quarter. Here's Filkey. Kick to centre half forward. Taken by Hart, who's worked pretty hard. Hodges the target, but poor kick. It never got to him.
I'm thinking of that league record, Bruce. It's 18 goals by Fred Fenning of Melbourne. Gordon Coventry kicked 17. So, like, he's got eight now.
And you kicked 16.
Yeah, got 16 once. But I'll tell you what, you've got to kick well and play well. And the way he's going, he could do it today, Tony Lockett. And no doubt they'll be looking for him now. Here's Tregenza receiving from Hughes to the half-forward line. And the mark taken by Muller. And all these St Kilda players lifting. Muller to the centre of the ground. Robert Harvey, good mark. Wide. Oh, they've got wide. Ralph Smith trying to soccer it off the ground. McGuinness. Tackled beautifully. Craven ridden into the ground, but certainly not a free kick deserved there. McAdam, where's Lockett? Lockett's gone back. Here's McAdam going short to Lockett. There is nothing you can do about that, Rodney Maynard.
Well, Maynard was in front, wasn't he? I mean, Lockett went back, then he went forward. I mean, and McAdam on the break, no pressure whatsoever. But the tackle started back here with Ralph Smith in the centre of the ground. The way he disposed of the Adelaide player. And St Kilda capitalised on it. They're just doing everything right, St Kilda.
10 marks to Lockett. This is a sensational display by the big full forward. No doubt about that. Coming back from a serious back injury. Can he kick his ninth? Oh, I think he's done it. Yes! 9 goals to Tony Lockett. 12-5 to Saints. Adelaide 1-6.
Well, they're just starting to go away too, St Kilda now. There was a tackle. Craven getting onto it. Morris, now McAdam. And McAdam using what speed. Then he goes for a bounce, confident. Then he decided to chip it, and Lockett was behind Maynard, went left, right, then John went out in front.
77-12 here. Hughes at centre half forward. Good looking kick, just missing. Don, starting to go away, the Saints.
Really, Bruce?
I think they were starting from about 2 minutes in the first quarter. Danny Hughes, they should use him on the ball because he has got a lot of strength and guts.
12-5-1-7. Micken and Bartlett stood their ground. Tregenza trapped it. Bartlett caught by Pekin. Daniels to Winmar. Where's Lockett again? One bounce. Kicks it sideways. Lockett the target. Will this be 10? One hand, no grab. Chance for Lee, bustled out of it. Rice in there. And can he kick 10 before half-time? That's the big question.
Well, we're just looking at these records. We go way back to 1945. Sal Murray kicked 10 for Richmond. Peter Hudson, 10 against Richmond.
In 71?
And Robert Walls for Carlton, also against Richmond in 76.
That's all before half-time, Don, is it? OK, McAdam. To the goal square. Lockett and Maynard. He's got it again. Well, won't this be a celebration? Here it is, number 10. He's put it through. No, he's going to have to come back. Well, an anti-climax suddenly. Couldn't play on after taking a mark.
Well, the umpire got Mr. Blame time on, did he? Because he took the mark and immediately raced out to the right. I can never understand that one, to be quite honest. Maybe the player was taking the mark and he had to get the OK, but...
Well, there's the angle. I've got a feeling...
Well, you see how fit he is. He's got his hands on his knees, Lockett, so he's blowing pretty hard.
Well, I've never... Here he goes, running out to the right to straighten up and kicks into the man. But I've never watched a game or commentated on a game when I've seen a player really in a position to break the league record like this. 18 has stood for a long, long time, and he's got a genuine chance today.
Smart and Morris. Morris off the ground for another one. It's all happening for the Saints. It's raining goals here. Well, Maradona would have been proud of that one. 13-5 to 1-7.
Really, you've just got to be here or watching it on TV to believe what is happening here. It's a massacre. It's an understatement. And everything St Kilda do is the right thing. Poor old Crows, they're just playing catch-up football.
13-5 to 1-7. It is very difficult to come down here and beat St Kilda at any time. Here's Nathan Burke. Klug. Oh, they've got the fumbles now. They've lost it again. Robert Harvey, brilliantly done. Can't quite trap it at the last moment. There's Filkey.
You're talking about full forwards now. I was involved in a game where Peter Hudson broke down in 1972, yep. And he had a purple patch just as Lockett. I think he kicked 8 goals.
And did his knee.
Just halfway through the second quarter.
And he was on Ray Biffin and Barry Burke. They collided. I remember that, Don. To half forward. Hodges having a tough battle up there against Frawley. Tregenza. It's still in play. Oh, everything going for the Saints. The kick from Jason Daniels is marked by Marshall. Marshall to half forward. Awesome pushing and shoving there in the pack. Hodges, oh, look at Frawley. Look at the strength of Frawley. Trying to shuffle it out. And, oh, gee, I haven't seen a St Kilda side so hungry and tough for a long, long time. They have really got a good lineup going at the moment. And if they can get Russell Jeffrey back on that side, Don, that'll help as well.
Well, he might be struggling to get back in because Ralph Smith's doing a good job, as is Grant. But these guys up the ground are being rewarded by the forwards down the ground, namely Lockett, so you can lift your performance.
Quick kick by Burke. Coughlin and Lindsay now peeking with a run of it. Sweeping handball, great football to Rice. He's got a paddock in front of him. And again for 3. Well, they're screaming for Tony, and he's kicked it to him. Nearly this time, Craven to the ground, and he snaps a magnificent-looking kick. It's another one. Well, the hair stands on the back of the neck when footy like this at the moment. It's champagne. It's creme de la creme, 14-5 to 1-7.
Well, this little bloke's got a lot of composure. He's only played about 10 games of league football. He broke his leg early on in the career. He's been down here for a long time, maybe 3 or 4 years. He's got a lot of pace. He's picking up Tony McGuinness, and he was instrumental in getting St Kilda going early in this game. Well done. He's only a little pocket battleship, but he's doing particularly well.
Well, this is a very, very disappointing game to watch. It's great to watch the skills of the Saints, but very disappointing. This is no contest. Here's Nathan Burke. Now Lockett's led to the pocket, but Burke's kicked straight into the man coming towards him in Filkey. Filkey, great tackle by Burke. Grabbed by Abernathy. Abernathy to centre wing, and the mark dropped out there by Picken. And the ball's kicked over the line. Now, is that on the full? I don't think so. It'll be a throw-in. Tim Picken being a great asset for St Kilda. Real goer. Get a game with Fitzroy now. I think he'd be first selected.
Funny how your football fortunes can change. Winmar, confidence does everything, doesn't it? Now McAdam looks for Lockett. Half volley. Handball. McAdam again.
Oh.
Again McAdam. Left foot. Brilliant. Hits a post. Bad luck, McAdam.
Actually, Lockett should have got a free kick then. He was dragged down by the chopper. He was very stiff then. It could have been another one. As he led for that ball, Maynard grabbed him by the jumper, as we see Lindsay to the half back line.
He's tried, this fellow, Micken, especially in the centre bounce work there, as at least he's got his share of hit outs.
He's improved, Don. Improved a lot.
Seven marks.
Micken, the centre of the ground. A one-handed attempt by Klug. Oh, the hand pass straight to Winmar. Clever hand pass. Muller to the half volley. Here comes Lockett. Oh, he couldn't grab that one. Dean Rice, McAdam, around the corner goes Gilbert McAdam, and he misses to the right. And what a dangerous forward line there, got down there.
Third point, McAdam.
Look at that, 13 goals. This will help the percentage.
Lindsay, Micken for his eighth mark on the 50-metre line. McGuinness has been quiet. I noticed him running past him a moment ago. Still Jarman off the ground. Centre wing. Winmar and kicks to the vacant spot. So less than a minute remaining of what's been a one-sided but in many ways outstanding half of football. Winmar, like Lockett, breathing pretty heavily. August the 11th, his last game of football, rubbed out for 10 weeks with the Brereton incident. Micken beaten to
the hell. Oh, come on, umpire, you're right there.
McAdam to Winmar, caught by Filkey.
I agree with you, Don.
Bartlett, quick handball to McDermott, sells a dummy on low, then goes short, and Micken takes his ninth mark at half-back.
A lot of that goes on, Peter, nowadays, holding off the ball.
Well, it was in front of the umpire who was dragged off the ball. I couldn't believe it either. There's the centre wing. Not that it'll make that much difference at the moment. Nathan Burke over the top. Peaking. Oh, still gets in his hand pass. That was a very poor tackle. Robert Harvey, they're just doing it as they like at the moment. Harvey to Lowe. He's shoved out of it. Stuart Lowe. Now he should get this moving quickly because he's got Lockett one out if he kicks it now. Well, he's going to have a shot from 50 metres, Stuart Lowe. The distance might be a doubtful. There's the siren to end a brilliant half of football here at Moorabbin by the Saints. St Kilda, 14-7-91, lead the Adelaide Crows, 1-7, a total of 13.
And that's a man who's been the focal point. An unbelievable comeback by Lockett. Out of the game for the whole of this season after that Foster's Cup injury against West Coast. And the 20-odd thousand, and I'll tell you what, a few might come down to the ground when they've heard the score at halftime to cheer on their hero with Winmar and McAdam, who have been absolutely brilliant. But they'll stand to a man and a woman and a child here when Lockett walks off, because he's given them all some joy here, but he hasn't given the Crows much. It's 91-13 at halftime at Moorabbin. Well, if he's okay, it's surprising he's sitting on the bench and keeping his bottom warm that way, because if Adelaide need anyone, it's Jarman right now. Abernethy around the corner. Micken and Peaken together. Hart snared it all right. Hughes wants it. Hart will chip it to Hughes at half forward and finds him. About 50 metres out. Plays on. Drop punt across the face of goal. Hodges, who hasn't had a kick at goal yet. Bickley, did he give a free kick away to Frawley? Muller. Burke, it's been a tremendous defence. And Micken takes the mark. And Pete McKenna, we've been talking about Lockett throughout the first half, as Winmar does greatly. But this defence has been pretty good. They've given away one goal.
Well, here they go again. Russell Morris, the long booming kick. Stuart Lowe, up go the big hands. It's a mark. Oh, don't tell me they're going to start the third quarter with a goal. Been a brilliant exhibition by St Kilda. I don't know about the opposition, though. That's been very, very poor.
Well, he's marked the spot, Peter. He's put a little divot in the turf as he went back, Stuart Lowe. Didn't seem to help last week.
No. Every time they did that last week, they missed against Carlton.
He kicked 1-4 last week.
Well, Stewie Lowe from about 40 metres, directly in front. Not well known for his straight kicking. That looked a lot better, though. Look at that. Right through the middle. That is Stuart Lowe's second goal. St Kilda go on from where they left off. 15-7 plays 1-7.
Well, he hasn't had a good year, Stuart Lowe. If we go back early in this game, it was a sign of an unconfident player. He fumbled the ball on three occasions. But then again, he's had the mantle all by himself up on that forward line without Lockett. Okay, Morris has been firing a little bit, but he's the one who's really had to shoulder the brunt of the forward line work. And it was a lot to ask of him. He's starting to gain his confidence. We saw on that occasion taking that one-hander. And he's just starting to find his feet. Let's hope he goes on, because he had a brilliant year last year. He was the club's best and fairest. And an underrated player for a number of years, Stuart Lowe.
15-1 at Moorabbin. A 14-goal margin. And the sun's shining brightly, and it's shining brightly on the 20 St Kilda players. Micken wins that tap. It doesn't go very far. Coughlin tackled. Kitschke off the ground. Winmar waits for it. Taps it on. It's all happening for them. Bickley finds a bit of space. Filkey. Let's hope Adelaide can play with some confidence and attack the goal front in the second half.
Really?
Took too long, Filkey, and then a very poor kick to Grant.
Well, what's wrong, Bruce, is that Hodges is on a lead and Filkey goes for another bounce, so Hodges out of position.
Winmar to Harvey, and this is the rebound that's been happening all day. One bounce. Waits for the last moment. Filkey puts some pressure on him, and Harvey doesn't do a good job of it in the end. Just he took too long as well.
Not many skill errors they've made today at the Saints, but that was one, a poor kick by Robert Harvey. This is Scott Lee, the centre wing. Good mark to Micken. Geez, improved Micken.
Mark number 11, Peter. Well, but he had a compaction injury last year. He's had problems with his calf muscles. Had it operated on pre-season, and he is, as you say, a much improved player.
Well, here's Filkey, a shocking kick to centre wing. Russell Morris, McAdam, brilliantly to Coughlin, smothered the handball. Lindsay dives on top of it, Tuttle balls it to Smart. This is Tregenza. McDermott can give it to Klug. Klug is on his own. Now he can give it over the top to Murphy. He does so. Now what will Murphy do? From 40 metres, straightens up, kicks a goal, and I think it's a goal to the Crows. Yes, it is. Michael Murphy kicks his second. The Adelaide Crows move on to 2-7, trailing the Saints 15-7.
Well, we kick one in the second, Murphy. And for an interstate team, you always know when they've kicked a major. There is just no reaction at all from the crowd. As Murphy sets sail, they haven't kicked too many of those, the Crows. In actual fact, Murphy has kicked their total goal score.
13-goal margin. Kitschke, Smart, who was the first of the trio trying to unlock it today, wide to Tregenza. Daniels has won that contest easily. Tregenza, free kick for a trip, and it'll go back to Simon Tregenza, the multiple premiership player from Port Adelaide. Now with the Crows, drop punt to centre wing, Marshall and over the back Murphy. Good mark, 6 goals against Footscray and a couple today. Looks for Klug on a lead. Muller with him. Pekin. Harvey and Murphy. Still with Murphy. Marshall tries to get hold of it. Kitschke with him. Quick handball away by Cummings. And the Saints get it away to Craven.
Danny Craven, a very, very... impressive little row, but beautiful kick too to Dean Rice. Now Lockett's one out. Now he elects to kick it wide to McAdam, who balked his opponent. Now it's Winmar. He'll try and hook it back to Lockett. He can't get it round enough. And he puts it out of bounds on the full. Well, actually, McAdam just held his ground there, as the Adelaide player did in the second quarter, really, didn't he?
Scott Lee.
Scott Lee, yes, on Lockett. But...
completely different.
What's that?
It was completely different to Scotty's episode.
Oh, well, it was.
You, once you get on the horse, you can't get off.
Well, it was a 50-metre penalty as well to Abernathy. Well, just reminding you, Don, that you might have made a mistake for once in your life. Abernathy to the half-forward line. Over the back is Pekin. Traps it well. Ralph Smith. Pekin again. Harvey. Off the side of the boot. Will it stay in? No, it won't. It bounces out on the full, so it'll be a penalty free kick to Bartlett. Number 14 for the Adelaide Crows, Alan Bartlett. Got a tough job on Stuart Lowe.
Hodges his target at centre-half forward, and he got underneath it and Grant over the back.
He's an underrated player, this fellow.
Is he ever?
He's missed a couple of matches through injury this year. Vital player to the Saints, can play anywhere across the back line and even up forward. Tregenza to Klug, finds him this time.
This player's got the knack of being in the right place at the right time, Klug. Always manages to get the ball away. And has held his position at centre-half forward. It's a difficult position to play.
Seven kicks, Bruce.
Let's see if he can kick his goal. And it'll be his first and the Crows third. Drop punt. Not going to quite make the distance. In front, Kitschke. Harvey read it beautifully. Kick towards Widmar. Waits for it. Fielke overruns it. Widmar with great skill to Harvey. He's an exhilarating player. Harvey to centre wing. Morris outnumbered. Smart. McAdam was lurking. Bartlett's hands to Abernethy. Just chips it over to Marshall at centre wing.
Marshall to the half forward line. Klug again. Thumped down by Muller. Still going with it, Muller. Bumped off the ball. He's got backup support from Craven. Craven again goes in to get it. Oh, he's a little workhorse. Klug battling hard. Lies on top of it. And the umpire deliberating, I think, there that both players were lying on top of the ball, and probably good umpiring there. Umpires Hayden Kennedy and Grant Vernon. The ball at half forward for the Crows. They've been really blitzed today. Lockett has kicked 9 goals for St Kilda. There's a holding the man decision. Will go to Grant. The advantage paid. Daniels looking for the hand pass. He's got Cummings running past. This is where the Saints are dangerous. He hooks it back to the centre of the ground.
Kick.
Beautiful kick, as Don Scott said. Now, Russell Morris kicks long. Lockett comes out, but he was a long way back. Micken takes yet another mark and gives it to Maynard,
who gives it to Hart in the centre. Klug on a lead. Muller with him. Klug holds his position well, takes a good mark. Excellent mark against Muller. Funnily enough, Adelaide enjoying their best patch for the whole match in the last 5 minutes. Klug, Hodges on a lead, cut out again. Grant doing a good job by coming over the back of Frawley. Ralph Smith's give was very good to Burke. With pace, Harvey goes to ground, gets up, no pressure at all. Then bangs it to low. Kenny half volley at the big fellow. Well, he keeps it in front and can't quite keep it in play. But wry smile there from the champion of 1990, winning the best and fairest at Moorabbin.
Gee, have a look at the build on him, isn't he? Big bloke.
He moves well too, doesn't he?
Oh,
he carries
does.
His weight well.
Widmar, brilliant. Ralph Smith resurrecting his career. Sean Ralph Smith to half forward. Scott Lee, he battles hard all the time. He gives 100%. Lee, a clever little chip pass. He's found Alan Bartlett. Bartlett to half forward was a bad kick. He kicks it straight to Kitschke.
He was looking for Kitschke on that occasion.
Hodges had a kick yet? I don't think he has. Kick by Kitschke out wide. This is Peakin. McAdam caught underneath it. Abernethy at the back. Rice tackled. Now Smart. Coughlin. Peakin. Short to Morris. Now Lockett on a lead. Morris to the goal square. And kicks her behind.
Well, I wonder whether he's a little selfish on that occasion. Because Lockett was on a good lead. He only had to use a 9-iron, chip it over the top.
And Lockett was 10 metres clear of Rodney Maynard too. So I thought they might go Lockett mad in this half too and try and really get him to kick a big double-figure score. There's Nigel Smart, the centre wing. Oh, good mark. Morris full of confidence. Under Harvey. Kitschke. Daniels now. Where's Lockett? Back he goes. Lockett pushing and shoving. Is that a holding decision? No. And Maynard playing close and hard. Good fullback plan. That occasions the ball rolls over the line.
I think he'd be deceptively strong, Rodney Maynard. He's a farmer.
Mickle and Lowe. Lowe in the front spot. Coughlin tries a fresh air shot. Oh, well done. Lockett gets another one. That's his 10th off the ground. 10 to Big Tony. 16-8-2-7. Almost anticlimactic there, the way he's kicked his 10. And Donna was set up when Coughlin had a fresh air shot here and then able to get it over to Lockett.
Yes, well, just watch this. There's Coughlin going. Now he taps it back, centred it well. Oh. And I thought that, well, again, we're in the wrong position, but it looked as if that was over the line when Lockett made contact with it.
10 goals to Tony Lockett. It wasn't his most brilliant. A little bit of luck involved then, but nevertheless, it's a goal. Shuffled out to Smart, and that was from Bickley to half forward Cummings. Oh, too easy in defence. Oh, Widmar, that should have been a free against Widmar. Not paid. That Adelaide Crows player had no chance whatsoever. Abernathy to the half forward line. Oh. Murphy was the flyer, couldn't take it. Oh, here they come again. Cummings, Ralph Smith gave the original hand pass. Centre wing is Filkey, keeps it in play. That was good play. Micken telling him to run on with it. The short one finds Hart. They're trying to get something going, the Crows. Marshall, Tregenza, breaks the tackle. Now a chance for Hodges. Hodges up in front of Frawley. Frawley gets it to ground. Oh, good play by Bickley. Bickley on the left foot, kicks it across the face. Oh, and it bounces back into play to Nathan Burke. Oh, this is St Kilda's day as he kicks it wide to Daniels, who's on his own.
Thought about taking Tregenza on, now called to play on. Well, it was a good kick by Daniels. He's been much maligned for his kicking. That one right down Morris's throat. And talk about improved and resurrecting. What about this fellow? It's his 13th kick playing at centre half forward. McAdam the target. Takes a long time to get there. Low, well done, big fellow. Wobbly one. Harvey and Smart. Courage by both players there. Rice. A sweeping handball to Coughlin. Coughlin's handball to Craven. Here's another one. Danny with a drop punt. And puts it through. And so he should smile the little rover. 17-8 to 2-7. Craven with his second goal.
Well, really, I cannot ever remember witnessing a game like this, where a team has been in such complete control, and everything that they do, St Kilda is coming off. If it was a mistake or a ball in dispute, it'll always go St Kilda's way. Everything is just going their way at the moment. It is just quite unbelievable.
I wasn't in Tasmania last week, but was Hawthorn and Fitzroy similar to this?
Well, it's a different type of game, wasn't it? It was a much scrappier game, Peter. This is a little bit more attractive, I suppose.
Not for the Adelaide Crows, I wouldn't think it's attractive. But there's number six, David Grant. Geez, an important player for St Kilda too. He gives a bit of solidity to that back line. Nathan Burke. Hand pass was from Ralph Smith. On to Dean Rice to the half forward line. Morris over the back, couldn't take the mark. Lindsay tried to crash his way through the pack. There's Abernathy, but the umpire in the meantime will come in and bounce at half forward for St Kilda. 17-8 plays 2-7, of which Tony Lockett has kicked 10. Craven has kicked 2. Stuart Lowe's kicked 2. The only goal scorer for the Adelaide Crows, Michael Murphy, with 2.
Saints in attack, Lowe and Micken, Harvey to Rice, chips it round the corner to McAdam, free kick against Abernathy. McAdam has been a star, sorry Don.
It's interesting, Stuart Lowe's going down under the goal square, and that's going to make it difficult for Lockett. But obviously, they work in tandem.
Micken lurking as well, so three Adelaide Crows versus the big two for the Saints. There's Lockett and Maynard.
It's interesting looking at the Adelaide Crows there in front and looking back at the two St Kilda forwards.
McAdam's kick, a good one right there to the square, but a behind, good distance, not quite the accuracy. 4 points to McAdam. I've got him down for 17-9
to
2-7.
Yeah, that's right, Bruce. 4 points.
And he kicked badly last week against Carlton too. He missed a couple of sitters. He would have made it
1-4 he kicked last week.
Yes, well, that's not good kicking, Nigel Smart. You're a wealth of information today,
Don. Well, I'm working with Bruce McAvaney, so something's got to rub off.
Boy, I'm glad you came today. The ball at half back. Bickley. But oh, plenty of good sides, better sides than the Adelaide Crows have come here over the years, Bruce, and been towed up by the Saints. Even when the Saints didn't have good sides, they often would beat top teams down here. Here's a quick kick to centre wing. Taken by Pekin. And the mark taken by Micken. He's having a good day. Bickley. Oh, receives it back. Bickley over the top. McGuinness has been quiet. Caught. And that could be holding the ball. In fact, it was a throw, the umpire said. free kick going the way of the Saints. And Tony McGinnis after BOG last week, not doing well today. Jason Daniels to half forward, low. Oh, what a strong grab.
They say he's got the best hands in the AFL. Maybe Kernaghan the only one that can go with him. Lockett shoves and pushes, gets away with it. Morris. And a free kick to Adelaide.
And Murphy's going off.
Murphy coming off and Jamison Ondon.
Yep.
They were two players that between them kicked 11 goals last Sunday night against Footscray. So 6 days has made an enormous difference. Good mark in the front spot by Marshall. Just wonder about McGinnis, Don. He just lacks that spark.
Well, they're changing him out of the forward pocket, Bruce, and Craven's doing particularly well on him. And then he's got Cummings when he goes down there.
Just wonder if he's fully fit. Hart to full forward. Hodges, finally. Nope, still not. Frawley, what a job he's done. Sweeping handball by Muller, good to Grant. And again, the Saints able to rebound. Morris the target. Micken getting back to help. McDermott caught. Now Smart. Hodges again calls for it. Again outnumbered. Frawley gives him a shove. Kitschke. Former double blue in Adelaide. Couple of bounces. Grant does the shepherding. Still Kitschke. A lumbering soldier as he kicks it to half forward. Morris. Well, it was either Morris or Lowe.
Nobody went with him.
Now Lockett gives him a lead. Morris kicks it to him. And Big Tony does the job again. Well, he's about 3 or 4 inches taller than Maynard.
Oh, sensational to watch, Don, isn't it?
It's just it is amazing, Peter. Look at him. I look back each time he goes for one of those marks, Peter. I go back to last year where he put his ankle underneath him, turned his ankle, and you always got that worry, haven't you?
Well, he's got such a big frame up top, but he's the best full forward I've seen play the game, Lockett. I've seen him down here a few times. Take outsides apart on his own. Absolutely win it off his own boot.
It's a big statement. You played in the same time as Wade and Hudson.
Well, if this man hadn't have copped injuries, it could have been anything.
Well, we're saying he's better than Dunstall. Drop punt by Lockett. Misses. Kick 10 still. And 17-10 to 2-7. Still, you should know what you're talking about. Well, you kicked a few yourself.
Well, I saw him 2 years ago. I said I made that statement in potential. Certainly in potential is the best full forward I've ever seen. And when a full forward can single-handedly win games, I mean, he's a champion. And that's what I think Lockett is. There's Micken again. He is the best player by a mile. And Marshall hasn't let them down either. He's tried hard.
This fellow's done well too.
He has. Sean Ralph Smith.
Played a lot of games in the reserves at Hawthorn. Just couldn't get into that senior side.
The funny thing is Sean Ralph Smith took the mark and they're all hooting Denny Hughes. Oh, there's Morris flying high. And it's a free kick against Morris for that. Bartlett will take it at half back. Nice kick to the half forward line over the back. It's all St Kilda reading the play. Cummings around the corner. He's found Winmar. Winmar can give it over to Harvey. Oh, they've created the loose man here. Danger for Adelaide. One bounce. Will he go again? No, he elects to kick it to Lockett. Here he comes, but he's got a teammate in front of McCannon.
Well, he could have spotted Rice. Rice made a better lead, but he decided to go against that and put it into Lockett. I think he would have been better advised to put it to the right instead of centering it because Rice was out by himself.
Gilbert McAdam, after a great game against Carlton last week, has had 17 kicks already, which is, he is a great player too. Gilbert McAdam from directly in front of, beautiful looking kick. Look at that, another one. McAdam kicks his first. 18 goals, 10 for the Saints. Adelaide 2-7.
I like the way this guy kicks for goal. Reminds me very much of Michael Moncrief, who had a very classical style in kicking for goal. Watch the way he keeps his head over the ball. Stays down over it.
...118-19 at Moorabbin. Morris to Coughlin. A daisy cutter, Lockett half volley. Caught by Maynard. Rice.
Oh, don't tell me.
Just a behind that time. Oh. That would have brought the stand down.
Well, that looked like a boomerang in flight, the way that was coming back, didn't it?
Well, it was.
But it was a boomerang, Don.
Well, it was turning.
18-11 to 2-7. I don't know if we are glad he came today, Peter. Kick by Smart. Looks for Micken, and Morris takes a great mark.
Well, Russell Morris is in sensational form at the moment. I saw him last week. 12 marks he's taken up on the forward line. There's Lowe. He's underneath that one, the mark taken by Abernathy. He played a great game last week on Stephen Kernahan in a losing side.
Don't tell me he's going to mark it again.
No. It's kicked off the ground by Nathan Burke. This is Pekin. Now, let's see if Lockett leads. Now, he's gone back, Lockett, here. Here's Micken. Oh, what a game by Micken. Terrific display by Mark Micken under extreme pressure. Maynard.
Muller's injured too, Peter.
This is Nigel Smart. Oh, he ran a long way. Oh, yes. He was looking at his forwards. No one was moving. Now they've lost it to Winmar. Winmar will set it up for the forwards. There's the kick. He's missed to the right. So they're not going Lockett conscious, really, are they?
No, good kick by Winmar, just missing 18-12, 2-7. 30 shots to 9. You'd have to seriously think that St Kilda's a final six team after this. There's Corns and Michael Taylor and Neil Curley in the background looking on. And it's going to be a pretty ordinary hour back on the flight tonight. Short kick to Bickley. Bickley from half-back. Kitschke in the front spot. Klug outnumbered. Muller with him, who Don said a moment ago, not moving 100%. Morris, who's continuing to grow in stature as this game goes on. Burke, Rice outnumbered. Smart, good attempt at the back, not paid. Coughlin, still with Rice and Lee. McAdam, still now Coughlin. Here's another chance. Coughlin in the pocket, turns round, bangs at a goal and misses. And suddenly the Saints, with an inaccurate period, at 18-13 to 2-7. So the margin is 17 goals.
Well, there'll be a lot of sides fighting for that final six, a lot of even sides this year, and this percentage will certainly help the Saints. There's a Micken again. Another mark. Tremendous.
Must be 14 or 15 marks he's taken.
Oh, that's a great effort. McGuinness with a hand pass over to Marshall. Marshall to halfwood. Their field kicking the Crows has been terrible. That was Muller. Oh, Nathan Burke, very, very clever. Daniels dummies the hand pass, then gives it straight to Jamieson. He finds Tregenza, who's been quiet. There's a tackle laid on Cummings. Pekin, Daniels. Daniels a wobbly one to full forward. Lockett takes front position, is grabbed. Couldn't hold the mark, it should be tapped through. No, he couldn't get his hand to it. There's Lowe. And eventually it's forced to the line, but the Adelaide player...
Now that's interesting because Hayden Kennedy was on the right side of Lockett and Maynard, and you could see the left hand of Maynard around Lockett, and he was not penalised. We'll go down to Max Stevens on the boundary line. Max?
Contrary to what I said at halftime, Andrew Jarman is injured, a shoulder injury, the same shoulder that gave him trouble earlier this year when he was forced not to play against the West Coast Eagles. He'll only return if really needed, and one trainer told me he could be out for a few weeks. Michael Murphy also off with an injured ankle.
Thanks for that, Max. Jamieson, Mrs. Hughes. So pretty obvious that something was wrong with Jarman, so it's bad news for Adelaide. Good handle by Daniels to Cummings to Craven. 1-2. Lockett on a lead. Too high the kick. Maynard, Lowe, Bartlett to Lee, to McDermott. Short to Abernathy. In fact, a bit long for Abernathy in the end. Morris against Tregenza, and that's symbolic of Adelaide today. But they had an opportunity to set something up, and the kick by McDermott was too strong and gave Abernathy very little chance.
Well, the way Morris is playing, I wonder if Hawthorn a little bit premature in getting rid of him. There's Tregenza. Well, he's playing so well. And he's hardly played a bad game all year, Russell Morris. Kitschke at half forward, the umpire calling play on. Oh, he dodges around quite easily. Damien Kitschke onto the left foot, up the half forward where the mark has been taken by Lee, and he's battling hard. Lee to the half back line, Tregenza, caught, drops it. Russell Morris again on the left foot, brings it back to the pocket. Lockett again, has it thumped away. He must be getting tired now. Craven has been great. Caught, gets his boot the ball, low at the back. Here's the dangerous McAdam. McAdam hooks it back at goal. And I think he might have missed.
He has. Just all you have to do down there is rely on the crowd to tell you that, Bruce.
1-5 to McAdam, 18-14 to 2-7. 122-19. Lee short to Maynard. Winmar tried to cut it off, couldn't. Back to Lee, should give it to Bartlett, he does. At halfback, he's got Filkey inside. Goes over the top of Lowe, now Filkey. He's had some touches, but geez, wasteful footy today. That's a better kick. Hughes well tried done. To tap it on. Muller. There's another Carlton Muller doing well. Marshall's handball, good to Bickley. Jamison on a wide leg, Grant after him. Jamison with McGuinness inside. McGuinness normally a thumping kick. That one okay to the goal square. Clue getting back. Muller in the front spot. Chance for Bickley. Still with Bickley. Good tackle on him by Ralph Smith. Chance for Klug. Snaps across the face of goal. And kicks it out of bounds.
The Crows battling hard. Certainly played a lot better in this quarter, but they've fallen down badly when they do get it to the forward line. That Saints defence has been great. Very strong players there in defence. Now, how will the umpires see that? Holding the ball against the Crows. It'll be a St Kilda free kick, and who'll unravel himself and take it? It's David Grant. Very good player, this man, Grant. He runs across the face. He's got a loose man out wide in Sean Ralph Smith. He's got him, former Hawthorn player, to centre wing. Vicky Winmar in front, taps it down. Well played by Filkey, ridden into the ground. And it will be a free kick to Grantley Filkey on centre wing. And a 50-metre penalty as well. 15 kicks to Filkey. And when he went to Collingwood, he wore the number of the great Collingwood player, Don.
Number 6, Peter McKenna.
Thank you. Got a good straight man here, haven't I?
Just feed him the lines, Macca.
Grant Filkey didn't really show his best at Collingwood, actually. Now the short one is on. That's good play to Lindsay. Lindsay will kick from 50 metres, so he'll take a good kick from there. As the time clock winds down, just under a minute of play left in this third quarter. Lindsay won't quite make the distance. They need a few players flying high for that one. Danny Hughes races back after it, but it beats him over the line.
Saints have kicked 4-7 to one goal by Adelaide in this quarter, so they've had 11 shots to one. Klug at the back, Bickley, Hart, Harvey Court, Rice, and St Kilda free kick.
Scott Hodges hasn't touched the ball today. Did you know that, Bruce?
Didn't I asked a few minutes ago if he'd had a kick. Didn't think he would have.
But not a handball either.
Here's Grant. Low the target. Less than 10 seconds now remaining in this third quarter. Filkey chips it to Hughes. Well, I don't know why he's getting the raspberries. He was on the receiving end of Lockett. His kick across the ground to Bickley as the siren will go now. Right on cue. And Bickley to have a shot from 55 metres out. Mark Bickley, who's kicked 3 points.
Actually, he should have been paid a 50-metre penalty because Jason Daniels went across the line.
Would have helped him a bit, Don. Torpedo punt. He's kicked it about 35 metres. So at three-quarter time, the Saints maintain their domination over the Crows. They lead 18-14.
122-19. 18-2. Lockett with 10. 9 to half-time. Kitschke with the tap. Daniels off the ground. McDermott leads in the race. Burke. Well snared by Tregenza. Little give by Lindsay was okay to Tregenza. To half forward. Jamison playing without confidence. Doesn't look the same player. That, 50 metres against Hart. Got caught there.
He went across the line. Now, that's what happened earlier when Bickley had that shot for goal. It was Daniels who went across the mark just the same there. He should have been given 50, Bickley.
Cummings roped him in there. It's happening a lot these days with the defenders running across in front, hoping the forwards will follow them.
The kick to half forward, low at the back. Is Bartlett shuffled back towards the half-back line. That was Scott Lee. Klug has it thumped the ground. There's Harvey. Oh, clever little soccer kick. That might come off to Ralph Smith, who's worked very, very hard. On it comes to Harvey. Oh, he ran a long way onto the left foot to the halfway line, and Frankie Coughlin. Coughlin versus McDermott. Oh, Coughlin might have been grabbed then. Tries to get in a hand pass, still battling away. Here's Tregenza. Can't pick it up. Oh, Bickley ran into a brick wall. Here's Russell Morris, been a great player.
Threw
that out. Oh, right, it comes to McAdam. That was from Pekin, and McAdam set sail for home and has missed, but a dead set throw out of that pack.
It was a questionable one by Pekin as well.
Well, since half time, the Crows have played a lot better, but the damage have been done in the first half. 18-15 plays 2-7, and there's McAdam and Abernathy having a bit of a dust up.
1-6 to McAdam, too, Peter.
He's smart. After the kick in from Lee. Up almost to centre wing. Bartlett in the front spot. Spore by Muller. Good football. Pekin to Winmar. Winmar squeezes one back towards Lowe. Lowe tries to give to Harvey, and he does. And Harvey from 30 metres with a drop punt straight through. 19-15 to 2-7. And Harvey's kicked his first.
Well, it really wasn't a good third quarter by St Kilda. They kicked 4-7. 11 shots for goal, only 4 goals coming, and they really did control play in that third quarter. They slowed down, and they've just got to lift their work rate just a little bit and capitalise on the scoreboard.
Well, the avalanche continues. That was Pekin getting it to the half forward line. Abernathy has taken the mark, and now he kicks wide. Oh, Danny Hughes has got a couple to beat. Ralph Smith's one of them, and it's been easy to play well today, but Sean Ralph Smith certainly has. That was Nathan Burke to Daniels, back to Ralph Smith. Now Harvey pushed in the back. Bickley to Klug. Klug setting up. Oh, Hodges still isn't going to get a kick here. Oh, Frawley, as easy as you like to Grant. Grant can give it back to Frawley, though he elects to kick it instead. Oh, Mark will free kick.
My.
Brilliantly done, Winmar. On to Danny Frawley, playing his 150th game, the captain, and hasn't played many bad ones in that 150 either. Bartlett breaks the tackle to centre wing. No mark. Shuffled on by Hodges. Bickley tackled hard. Here's Cummings, and the umpire says a free kick to Bickley.
In the centre square, Klug's it in the full forward spot, gives the lead. Muller goes early. Klug stood his ground. Tackle on him by Ralph Smith. Hart paddles it out to Hughes. Hart's handball only as far as Grant. Again, this mean St Kilda defence. I'll be pretty pleased when they come off today after only 2 or 3 goals have been kicked against them. McDermott, no free kick. Tregenza has mishandled a lot today. And Daniels with him. And it'll be a throw-in in front of the adoring St Kilda crowd. They've loved what they've seen today. Hughes and Kitschke. Kitschke at the back. Tregenza. Marshall goes for a Burke. Goes on top of it. McGuinness has been quiet.
Tackle.
Yes, Craven brilliant there. Winmar to Harvey with pace. A bounce. Rice is the target. Kicks it out in front of him. Rice with high skills. Now Lockett leads. Will he kick it down his throat or go for goal? Goes for goal and misses. Kicks a point. Well, that was another 9-9 there, Don, if he wanted.
What, did he use a free, Bruce?
Yeah, and just mishit it, didn't he? Just hooked it a bit.
Yeah, I think he could have given that one to Lockett, actually. The lead was good.
Kitschke's gone off for the Saints.
Maynard. To the half-back line. Harvey. Pekin, the leader's on to Lockett. Here he comes. Great lead, great pass.
Well, he's only kicked one, Peter, since half-time, Tony Lockett.
That was off the ground, but he's taken 13 marks in a magnificent display. And have a look at this pass.
1-1 since half-time.
Well, he's had 16 kicks. He's kicking for goal number 11. His goal in the third quarter was off the ground from about 2 inches out. But his first half was sensational and missed a couple as well. And the big fella's back in town. He's a great player. Takes plenty of time over his kick. There's the drop punt. He hooked it slightly. And he has missed to the left. He's not happy with himself. He's kicked 10 and he wants to get a few more.
What have you got him down for, Don? I got him for 10-5.
10-5, Bruce. 10-5.
Well, it's understandable, having not having the match practice or the shooting for goal, so he'll take a while to get back into it.
Well, Lee takes on Lockett. Lockett tried to run him down to centre wing.
I hope to see when he actually does come back into it.
I'm talking about kicking for goal.
Oh, though. I see.
10 every week would be handy, wouldn't it? Vidovic. That'll make 220 for the year. Short. Morris. McDermott tries to half volley. Harvey holds him up. Marshall. Morris, who's been magnificent today. High in St Kilda's best. McDermott to Lindsay. From half back. And goes towards Klug. Muller in the front spot.
Well, Ian Muller's held his place in the St Kilda side.
Had a wretched run with injuries over the years since coming from Carlton.
Knee operation discarded by Carlton, as Don said, as the ball is forced over the line again. But since half-time, well before half-time, Spark gone right out of this game. The game was won long, long time ago, probably in the first 5 minutes, as a matter of fact. Disappointing for the Crows. McDermott. And they've got problems with Chris McDermott. He is really not firing up. Hart. A short one finds Filkey. Filkey will kick from... Well, he's had 17 kicks, Grant Filkey. Kick from 49 metres. There's the drop punt right out to the pocket. Klug has it pumped away. It's still in play, actually. Danny Hughes takes it over the line. And it will be a throw-in.
131-19. Hughes, who was involved in that incident with Lockett in the second quarter, when tempers and tension were high here. Vidovic, and again another throw in. But as Peter McKenna said a moment ago, the spark's gone. The fuse was ignited a long time ago, and they're really just playing it out now with about 20 minutes remaining, including time on to come. Ralph Smith. And this mean St Kilda defence just giving away 19 points well into the final quarter.
Well, this is the most talent they've had at St Kilda for many, many years.
Well, it might be their big chance. Here's McGuinness caught. Craven found a rover in this fellow. Craven to Morris. And they might have found a centre-half forward in this guy as well. Confidence is sky high. It took him a long time to get over that bump in Brisbane that day. And he might be well and truly back. No free kick. There'll be a throw-in on centre wing. Marshall and Peakin. Good contest there.
They're winning by, about 19, 20 goals. And the St Kilda supporters still want the free kicks for just about anything. Oh, look at the show of strength there. Micken versus Lowe. Oh, that's holding the ball. No. McDermott. Harvey. Oh, well done by Harvey. And not being able to get away with it was Cotlin. And the crowd are making plenty of noise. Our commentary area. Right in the one-eyed section.
And they really should penalise these two ruckmen. They were holding before pushing. They don't use their bodies. Now that's a better contest.
Over the back is Bartlett. Oh, that's holding it. Oh, lucky to get away with that. Craven, a quick kick to half-court Abernethy. Oh, well done. Took a good mark on McCannon there.
He's got Filkey wide. This will be his 18th kick. Stephen Newport about to come on for St Kilda. Well, he gives the handball up, Filkey, to Zalee. Peakin coming off. Lee's kicked the centre-half forward. Hughes with a juggled mark, not paid. Frawley over the top. Free kick to Hughes. Too high. Seventh kick coming up, and you can see Frawley right over the top. Hasn't kicked a lot of goals in AFL, 23 to be exact. This is his 129th game. Nearly all of Danny's football at fullback from Melbourne. Drop punt. Good kick, and he's kicked it. So the Crows get their third. 19-17 to 3-7.
Well, it's a long time coming. Hughes starting on interchange. He was brought on because Smart couldn't hold Lockett early in the game. And then Hughes, unfortunately, copped Lockett when he was in full cry. And made a change, got him up to the forward line. He has worked particularly hard on that forward line, Hughes. He's got a lot of courage. He's prepared to put his body in.
Micken. Let's see, missed the hit out. It was tipped over the back by Dean Morris. Morris on to Coughlin. Coughlin on the left foot looking for Lowe. Lowe comes out in front and gets in a quick hand pass. Goes to get it again. He's got Harvey in support. Also there was Coughlin. Here's McAdam. Oh, beautifully to Craven. The little fella trying to get round to get a kick.
Dropping
in.
Dropping it.
Umpire calls play on. The player's crashing after. Well done by Daniels. On to McAdam. He's bumped off the ball. Marshall. Ooh, oh, top one. Or the secure the player down. I think it's Winmar.
It was pretty crude by Winmar.
Well, he went in to lay the tackle and has hurt himself and he's down. This is Tregenza to McDermott. McDermott to the half forward line. Grant at the back. Thumps it away. He's a good player, David Grant. Very, very good player. And kicks it and puts it over the line.
Could have been on the full, actually. There's Nicky Winmar. He seems to be all right. Just a little sore.
Klug and Vidovic. Rice with a thumping torpedo punt. Lowe outnumbered there. McAdam for the spoils. Winmar, if he's fit enough. Now Harvey. Couldn't quite get it to Winmar. Still Harvey. Goes for goal. And puts it through. Another one. Number 20 for the Saints. And Robert Harvey coming home with a rush with his second goal in this last quarter.
We had 30 possessions last week, Harvey. 17-13. This game becoming rather boring now. A lot of interest in the first half on what Tony Lockett would do, but Lockett's gone out of the game. Other players are starting to kick goals. In fact, St Kilda really have slowed down since half-time. To half-time, kicked 91 points.
19 kicks to Robert Harvey. As the Saints go forward again through Craven, a wobbly one, or they've got to wait underneath it. Abernathy held his ground. That was a good mark. Bruce Abernathy has had 13 kicks, 28 years of age, had stints at North Melbourne. He was an exciting player when he came to North. Then he went to Collingwood, now back in Adelaide. Scott Hodges, oh, he still hasn't got his, well, he got his first touch, but it's not a mark or a kick. Or a handball as the kick from McGuinness comes to half forward. Ralph Smith. Now it's Nathan Burke. Burke to the half back line. Oh, the mark is dropped down there by Marshall. Grabbed by Bickley. Bickley back to Marshall. Marshall at half forward. Sets it up for his forwards to take a mark. Kluger's there. Bumped away to Muller. Muller to the half back line. It's all St Kilda. Hand pass comes back to Dean Rice. That was from Coughlin. That's Cummings to the half-forward line. Awesome courage shown there. Oh, Lockett. The push in the back. The umpire has paid to Maynard. It was a little bit high, that tackle.
Short to Lee. At half-back, good kick to Klug. Target Marshall in the centre square. Jamison wide for him. He's not going to get that far. Poor kick by Marshall. Cummings, who's been pretty impressive. Newport's first touch, poor kick, Lowe and Micken. Now Bartlett from half back. Good kick to McDermott. Can they set something up here? Klug runs for him. Tregenza goes towards Klug in the pocket. Grant loves these positions where he can come and fly and then thump it into about the 15th row in the terraces.
Is that deliberate, was it, Bruce?
Well, it was.
Well, actually, believe it or not, at times that is, but it'd take a game umpire.
Well, can I pose a question? Has Rodney Maynard done particularly well in the second half? Because, well, he's kept Lockett to 1-1.
Right.
Or is it the fact that Lockett...
I don't think the game's actually gone Lockett's way. He hasn't really... Although the ball's going down there, a lot of the players have had shots from the 30 to 40 metre mark. But Maynard, give him his due, he does stick close and works hard. And he's done a very good job.
Bottom line's got to be that Lockett's had fewer opportunities because Maynard hasn't beaten him in many one-on-one contests.
No, that's exactly right. So the ball just hasn't been going Lockett's way.
Well, here's Muller from half-back. Took straight to Abernathy and Abernathy marks. On he goes to Bartlett. Bartlett to the half-forward line. Denny Hughes at the back. Can't mark it. It's tapped on to Frawley. Frawley crashes his way through. What a good player he's been for the Saints.
Now, is that deliberate?
No.
But he went straight for the boundary line.
Well, a clever little kick. He might have been hoping it would bounce in, gone, maybe.
Do you think so, Peter?
Well, it was a
A good defensive kick anyway.
Klug and Vidovic. Filkey. Burke. One of a number of good players.
He's a good player. They've got a great back line.
Hate to be having to pick 1, 2, 3 for the Saints. Be a tough job.
I've got to do it.
Craven. Too far for Newport. Micken to Filkey. Now Hughes the target. Grant at the back. Muller. Craven. Good kick to Winmar by Craven. Great handball to Rice. Now Lockett on a lead. Not a good kick though.
That's probably
Lockett's frustration in the second half as the ball hasn't got to him like it did in the first.
That's right. And also, Lockett would be feeling the pinch. And probably not leading as much. Scott Lee has battled hard in a losing side. It's not easy to play in the back pocket of the ball. Been crunched down time and time again. Cummings has been most
impressive. Not bad, is he, Cummings? He's good on both sides of his body. That was a left foot kick, and he's delivered the ball well on the right side as well.
Daniels, or a poor kick. McGuinness. Now it's Bickley to Marshall. Marshall up to the forward line. Hughes flies. But taking a nice strong mark is Sean Ralph-Smith.
Chips it to Burke at centre half-back. Sweeps it back to Ralph-Smith. Well, we've talked about his improvement. Here's Newport. Now Harvey. Some Kilda players everywhere on their own. He's got Morris alone at centre half forward. McDermott late. Morris had to sit underneath it for a fair while. McDermott to Micken to Lee. Went without it.
Oh, whoa.
What about that one?
Whoa.
Tunnel ball throw. What a ripper.
Well, something like Joe Montana gets those every week playing for the 49ers.
Have a look at this. You couldn't believe this unless you saw it. Oh, you didn't see it.
Well, you wouldn't have believed it anyway, Don. Coughlin from 30 metres out after a horrible mistake by Lee. And Frankie for his first. And St Kilda's 21st. And drop punt and it's through. Another one. The Saints have got 21 of them, and Coughlin gets his first, 143-25. The margin, 18 goals, 10.
Well, they have slowed down in the second half. 52 points they've kicked. Up till the half-time, they kicked 91 St Kilda, and they were really looking good.
Well, Adelaide hasn't accelerated too much. They
I don't suppose.
13 points in the first half and 12 in the second.
Well, look at that scoreline, 21-17 to 3-7. There's Vidovic, there's beaten by Micken. Oh, he caught one, he's got the boots into the groin area too, Mark Micken. He's down. Centre wing is Nathan Burke. And Don, that was one of your old tactics at the centre bounce. The ruckman, they go in now with those boots out, don't they?
What are you inferring?
Well, that's what he copped. He copped one in the groin.
Well, if you play in that position, that's what's going to happen.
Well, that time they might have to wear the old cricket protectors, I think. The way things are going at the centre bounces on fair dinkum, too.
You would have been right.
Here's the ball on centre. That was Robert Harvey giving in the hand pass to Stephen Newport. Newport. Well, he's spent most of the day on the bench. Oh, here's Russell Morris again. Well, has he had a picnic? Now, one out down there is Lockett. If he kicks it now, he's waiting a little bit too long. 14 marks. Now, Lockett at the back. Up he goes. Bumped off the ball. Frankie Coughlin lies on top of it. Tries to get out to Lockett. Quick kick to low, but it eludes his outstretched hands and through for a behind. So Lockett for the day has kicked 10. Is it 10-6?
10-6.
10 goals, 6 to Tony Lockett. A great return.
Scott Lee. Nigel Smart, the target.
Oh, well done, Lowe.
Maynard. To Filkey, who I think has now had 19 kicks. To centre half forward. Make that 20. Thanks, Tom. Burke from centre half back. Thumps it down to Harvey. Here's a space here. They've got some chances. Now Winmar's got Lockett on the goal square. He's going to kick it to him.
And the big boy wouldn't miss that one.
Oh, that was coming a long way out, wasn't it? Winmar sized that up beautifully.
Yeah, it was a good kick by Winmar. And Scott Liu is in front. It's just no match. Watch this. Just a mismatch in height. And Lockett had the sit.
14 marks, Bruce.
Well, it's been a remarkable performance.
Well, if he kicks this, he goes up with Gordon Coventry, Bill Toomey and Michael Roach, who have all kicked 11 in this round.
Well, he'll kick it, Don.
Some famous names there.
Straight through, mate. There's his 11.
22-18 to 3-7.
That's his second goal for the half, Tony Lockett. Bill Toomey, 1950, kicked 11 against Footscray. He played for Collingwood. Michael Roach, Richmond, also against Footscray in 1980. And Gordon Coventry, a Collingwood forward, probably the greatest full forward at Collingwood, against St Kilda in 1927.
Well, 11 goals to Tony Lockett. Great performance. But a great performance by St Kilda all round. It's going to take a very good side to beat St Kilda. Now they're back at full strength. Here's one of them too. Oh, has he made a difference? David Grant. Tremendous exhibition. Frankie Coughlin got underneath that one. Smart. Gets it to Bickley. Then on to Lindsay. Marshall to the halfway line. The mark has been taken by Klug. Now Klug will kick from 35. Almost directly in front. Klug has taken 7 marks. Well, that's a good strong one. And he's had 10 kicks. Always battles hard, John Klug. Always looks slow, but tends to get in the right position at the right time. John Klug kicks a goal. Beautiful kick right through the middle. That's his first. And the Adelaide Crows have kicked their fourth. 4-7 to 22-18.
Had a good week last week. 3 goals to Klug. Centre-half forward. There he is, getting in front of, or just coming over the top of Muller. And a good kick.
150 to 31. 119 point margin.
The Saints lead by 18 goals, 9. After Klug kicks Adelaide's fourth. Vidovic and Micken. McGuinness, high tackle.
Oh, nicked. Hadn't made a mistake up till three-quarter time. Stephen Newport's made 2 since, well, in this last quarter.
Pretty hard when you're sitting on the bench, Don, to make a mistake. McGuinness to Abernethy. To half-forward. Hughes, oh, good mark taken by Ralph Smith to Burke. Well, we talked about Russell Jeffrey and a couple of players that will try and get back in. It's going to be hard to force your way into the St Kilda side for a few weeks. Morris, back to Newport. Lowe and Bartlett. Rice. Lindsay with him. And Abernethy, who's had a good last quarter, Bruce Abernethy. Back to Filkey. He's got Bickley running inside, outside of him. He'll use him now. Hughes very short. Bickley takes Burke on, gets caught. And that's really been the story of the day. The St Kilda tackling's been wonderful. And Cummings, if he's wasted a kick, I haven't seen it. To Coughlin. To Daniels. Where's Big Tony? He's short.
Drop it short.
Well, Daniels will go for goal. Drop punt. And he puts it through. It's another one. 23 of them.
Well, Don, they're finishing it off now, the Saints.
Well, they're starting to slip it up into third against Bruce, but Daniels on that occasion had Lockett out in front. He could have chipped it across here because Lockett was on a good lead. Neglected the lead, Daniels, and really he had to make amends for it, and he did in the right way, and that was on the scoreboard with a goal.
Brilliant display this by the Saints. Just under 4 minutes of play left. All interest now to see how many Lockett will end up with. There's Craven. Morris has been great at half forward. Harvey looking for Daniels. On to Newport. The leader's on. Lockett. Yes, easy as you like. Maynard has given up the ghost, I think, at this stage. That's twice Maynard's just waited back. But I don't blame him in a way because he had no chance. Lockett said, thank you very much for goal number 12 coming up.
Well, number 14, well, 14 goals have been kicked, and that was by a grateful forward, John Coleman.
I thought you were going to tell me Lockett had kicked 14 for a minute, Don, but this is Lockett going for goal number 12 in a magnificent display of full forward work. coming back after a long way off. Oh, did he sneak it in for a goal? Let's have a look. Yes! 12 goals to the St Kilda champ. 24-18, the Saints. Adelaide 4-7.
Well, it was unselfish play by Newport. He was on his left foot. It wasn't a good pass, although it was out in front. Here it is. But the ball didn't come off the boot in the way Newport would have liked it. But still there, not spinning in the best way, but Lockett in front, chipped it across. Well done, Newport.
162-31. They're celebrating in the terraces here, Jim Muller and Lindsay. It was a sickening blow, wasn't it? It was a chilling
And he's not too good either. He's back in the centre of the ground. There he is. I think he'll get to his feet. He's copped a couple of bad ones today.
Perfectly fair. I mean, they both have their eye on the footy.
He's all right, which is good to see.
But the celebration will be long and hard at Moorabbin tonight. Marshall's quick kick. Hart and also Cummings. Cummings has been terrific. Here's McGuinness, who's been very quiet. Round his body, Jamieson. Well, he was taking those the other night. Grant's been magnificent.
Fantastic.
But, gee, Tats of mates. Daniels runs it over the line.
His use of the body then, Grant, when he was out of position, was just sensational stuff.
Tregenza and Daniels. But you wouldn't have to be Einstein to work out whose name will be on everyone's lips in St Kilda tonight. They'll be Lockett crazy. Hodges taps it on. McDermott from 60 metres. Good kick. The Crows with a chance here. Hughes at the back. But again, Grant able to get in there. Muller, quick recovery after being flattened a moment ago. Cummings. His kicking's been magnificent. This time he singles out Morris and he finds him.
Well, Morris has nearly been best man in the ground, really. He's taken 15 marks. Low. Just shoved out of it. A hand pass was from Scott Lee. McDermott, cop one across the ear. Daniels, marks, centre wing. Time clock ticking down. Can Lockett get another one? Crawley, wide. McAdam leading in the race. He's got Abernathy to beat. The two number five still going on with a good
he
play,
was
Abernathy.
Held.
Oh, I don't know. I think
he was held. His arm was held by Abernathy.
Well, I thought Abernathy did very, very well to keep that ball underneath then. It was a good effort.
It was a good contest between two highly skilled players. Abernathy having a good last quarter. McAdam's had a terrific match. Filkey's had a lot of kicks. This one to Klug. Muller at the back. Rice, 21 kicks to Filkey. And both Rice and Klug on it as we're into the last 45 seconds of what's been a one-sided but quite remarkable game. Lockett with 12 goals, 6. Klug, Lindsay, Marshall. So 30 seconds to go. Hughes gets into the front spot. Tapped on by Bickley. Daniels caught. Free kick to Daniels in the back. Allowed to play on. I guess the one thing that would finish this off would be a Lockett goal in the last 20 seconds. Can it happen? Well, he kicked one in the first minute. Here's Coughlin. Could they get it to him? Is that asking too much? Winmar could be just the man. Lockett on the lead.
Look
at this. Big Tony sets himself. But Bartlett comes in and spoils what would have been a fairy tale ending. Lee, and that's it. It's all over. The Saints by 20 goals, 7. It's 24-18, 162 to 4-7-31. And Peter McKenna, you kicked 16 one day and kicked over 800, I think. But this man has come back to town with a vengeance today.
Well, it's been a fantastic display of the whole St Kilda side. But look at the young supporters after the big full forward, and great to have such a personality back, a player with enormous ability. So is Nicky Winmar, both champion players in their own right. It is just absolutely tremendous to have these both these champion players back in that St Kilda side. Lockett 12 goals, Winmar was great, and look at the adulation of the young Saint fans.
Well, it's got to be one of the great moments in the sport, this. Well, that says it all. And if the Saints are going to challenge for the premiership, this big boy here must stay fit and stay on the field. Because today, he has come back in emphatic fashion and he raises his hand and goes down the stadium, and Kenny Sheldon must think, thank God he's back. And back he is with 12 big ones today. So the Saints win at Moorabbin. They win by plenty.
24-18, 162 to Adelaide, 4-7, 31.